Okay, for our next step, the final kind of step, we're going to make the mallet to bonk these little guys down through their holes. We do that is start with the mallet head. So I'm going to start with the sketch. There's a lot going on here and it's kind of not that cool. So let's go ahead and make everything invisible. And let's turn the visibility back on construction. So make sure your construction visibility is on. There's one plane floating out there in space. That's fine. We're going to go ahead and make a new sketch and let's put it on this plane this time. And the mallet starts with making a rectangle. So way over here, I'm just going to start drawing a rectangle and dimension it. This short dimension is 0.875. I hit tab and the other dimension is 3. Let's zoom in a little bit with the mouse wheel and just kind of make a few little circles here and about here. And this is just for looks, folks. I'm going to use the equals constraint up at the top. Click one of the circles, click the other one, and now they're the exact same size. So when you get that done, go ahead and finish the sketch. We're going to choose revolve. It's right next to extrude. Select your big shape. Leave the circles out, okay? We're going to make it a... Let's just leave it as a new body. Our axis is going to be this side over here. And real quickly, boom, you've got the head of a mallet. It's pretty cool. Our next step is to throw a plane on here so we can put the handle on the mallet and call it a day. So construct, to get the planes open, we want a tangent plane and the face we want is right here. So all that did was put a tangent plane on that face. You say okay. Once that's there, you can put a sketch on the plane. Now we're looking at it and we're sketching right here. We're going to make a circle right in the center of everything. And I think we want that to be 0.5. Enter. And does that look like it's fat enough? Let's go 0.75. A little bit bigger. And this will be the, maybe that's too big. Oh, I'm just going to leave it anywhere between 0.5 and 0.75, whatever you think is the best aesthetic. We're going to go ahead and finish the sketch. We're going to extrude cut this in a half an inch. So where it says new body down here, we're going to make it a cut. I'm going to start dragging it this way. And if you're lucky like me, you'll get it to stop. Otherwise, you have to hit negative 0.5 inches, and that'll give you your hole. Let's go ahead and click there and click extrude and click the inside of your hole. We're going to drag this out. How far? 5 inches. 5 inches is great. And say, okay, now we've got a whole mallet. It's not the greatest, but this is an opportunity for you to kind of mess around, especially if you've got a couple extra minutes waiting for other people to catch up. So you can make your handle a little weird. You can make your mallet head a little weird. It's all up to you. We've got two body. We got body two over here under our bodies, and we're just going to change that into a component. So create components from bodies. Component seven, we're going to call it the mallet. And you can call it the hammer. You can call it whatever you like. And then if we turn everything back on, we should have the whole setup ready for what comes next. Let's go ahead and change the mallet's appearance to something that looks a little better. So appearance, bodies, components, and how about a nice walnut? Let's make the mallet a walnut. Oh, that looks horrible. How about pine? Let's try pine. Oh, that shows up a little bit better. So change the appearances, make everything look kind of neat and cool. And in our next steps, we're gonna learn about moving things around, making exploded views, and eventually making renderings and drawings from our work. Thank you.